It's Caroline from the St. Drainer, and it is day 13 of the Lockdown Workout Challenge. It's also Sunday. Happy Sunday. Before we start today, I just wanted to say thank you if you've been following and you've made it this far. You may notice in the description below, I've added a little link, which is a donation link to my PayPal account. As you know, probably, from the news, a lot of small businesses are being affected, and obviously I can't work with my clients physically at the moment. And with a lot of them having children and things, they can't do virtual either. I do offer virtual online sessions that are live for 1 hour. So if you're interested, please contact me. The information is below. But yes, I realise it is a tight time for anyone and everybody at the moment. If you do have a few pennies to spare and you would like to offer me a donation because you've enjoyed the exercises and you found them useful, then please do. If not, don't worry, I make these purely for joy, to encourage people to get moving and also to keep myself accountable. So today we have one of our last workouts, and of course at some point we knew this would come. It's going to be a Tabata toilet roll workout. I hope that this isn't salt in the wound for some people, especially in the UK. I think everybody's okay with their toilet roll situation right now. It's not so bad over here, but I actually saw Kayser Fit. Kayser? I hope that's the way to say it. I love her. She's amazing. Doing a toilet roll workout about maybe 2 years ago, 3 years ago, I don't know, first time I saw it on Instagram, and I thought it was brilliant. Now it seems even more relevant. I have tried to change different exercises, so not to be a copycat of her, but I'm also running out of household items to use. So I have got 4 toilet rolls. Oh, fix them up. You can use 2, you can use 3, it actually doesn't matter, but I expect most people have got around 4 in their house. Preferably still attached, so they're not going to unroll as you use them. So we've done Tabata before. It's going to be 20 seconds off, 20 seconds on of work and 10 seconds off. So it's going to be nice and speedy, and it's mostly full body and abs today. We did bum yesterday, so we're going to try and use different parts of our body, and these lend themselves very well to that. So we're going to do, instead of just 4 exercises, we're actually going to do 8 exercises. So we're going to do 4, and then another 4, and then go back to the first 4, and then the second 4 again. And then we'll be done. So it's going to be nice and quick, and I'm going to show you what we are doing. So the first exercise, you're going to set yourself kind of like goalposts. Because the up, up, down, you're just going to run and touch down. I want you to try and get past your toilet rolls each time. Yeah, and you're going to go really fast. As fast as you can for 20 seconds. That's number one. The second one, you're going to be using 2 of the toilet rolls. We're going to put one on the floor. I'm going to move these ones out of the way. You can sit on your mat for this because we're going to be moving around. And we're going to make a clock. So you're going to start with one in between your feet. You're going to lift up and over and put it down. You're going to take the next one and put it down. Take the first one again, down. And we're going to go around with straight legs, like that, hopefully, coming all the way around, back to the beginning, depends how fast you are. And then, this one can change depending on your level of fitness. I'm going to use 2. You could equally use 3 or 4 to make it higher. All you're going to do, put your toilet rolls down, and we're going to squat jump. You're going to sit down on them as if you're sitting on the toilet. It's going to give you a great squat position, and you want to get lower than 90. So you're going to touch your bum to them and jump up. It's quite a lot of effort. And then number 4, we are going to use all 4 of them again. You're going to have 2 at the edge of your mat, and then 2 at the end. You want to put them kind of on the edge of your mat. And we are going to do a plank position. You're going to, ooh, that's going to be a bit wide. Keep them inside the mat. You're going to step your hands out and then jump in, jump out. Step your hands in, jump out. So we're using them almost like cones. That's the first four. Got it? The second four is, we're going to line them up, and we're going to do quick feet. Sorry, I can't see the edge of my screen, so I'm never quite sure. I know when I did some workout the other day, I couldn't see my feet, but I wasn't about to refilm it. You're going to tap, 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 all the way along and back, but fast. Kind of like a footballer. Quick feet, quick feet, quick feet. 20 seconds. Then we're going to do an ab exercise, but you only need one. I'm going to turn my back. This one is going to be a combo. So you're going to do, the roll is going to be in your feet. You're going to reach up to touch your feet. Then you're going to put your hands down and lift up your hips, squeezing the roll in between your feet. Reach up and up. So hands go up, hips go up. Hands go up, hips go up. That's that one. Number seven is, we are going to stand up. Again, we're just one roll. Hands wide, legs wide. You're gonna lift your leg all the way up and put the toilet roll underneath. Same on the other side, and then you're gonna squat down, pass the toilet roll around and through your legs. And I want you to keep your stomach really tight when you do that through so you can be nice and quick. You come back up. One, two, through, and I want the big arms. It takes a lot more energy to do with a long straight arm. It's a bigger lever. More weight to it, even though these are light, we can still make it difficult. And the very last one is a ab exercise as well. So these are called star V-ups. However, you're gonna have two toilet rolls, you're laying in a star shape on the floor, a snow angel, and you're gonna scoop your hands in to bring you up, and you're gonna lift your legs up, and you're gonna tap the rolls underneath. Scoop, tap, scoop, tap. So try to go back to that star shape after each one. And then you'll be finished. Okay, so sorry, this has been a little bit of a long message before, obviously, and you probably do just skip through to the exercise, to the actual workout if you don't need to listen to these instructions, but I'm hoping to make it available for all, so some people might need a little bit more explanation. Okay, I'm gonna put some music on and we are going to get to it. Okay, so if you didn't do the other Tabata exercise, just to let you know, I'm gonna time it for you. If you want to do this at home, you can use your phone or you can just Google Tabata timer and you can fill in the rest and the workout sections, and that makes it really easy, okay? So, let's get to it. Run down, so you need two and two. Don't do this in socks, please. You've got 10 seconds to prepare. It's 8 minutes and 40, plus we're going to have little rests in between. Okay, here we go. Down low. Every time you touch. Good, okay. Second one is the clock one. You just need two. Isn't that fun to move those ones? So you can get round, come back to the front. Just about. Okay, low squats. In the middle. Squat jumps, here we go. Do whatever you want with your hands, it keeps you motivated to go. 10 seconds.
10 seconds. Good, okay. Last one. Plank.
Fast to get yourself organized, so I'm going to put up to 15 seconds in between each exercise. We're just going to have 30, 45 seconds rest now. My hair is fluffy today, so I washed it yesterday. Do you hear how much I'm puffing just from doing those four exercises? And I can tell you I've got good cardio, good lung capacity, good endurance, but still, if you push yourself hard enough, that's going to be really difficult. Okay, let's go into the second two. Line up for your quick feet. Here we go. So work away a long line. Try not to kick them off. If you can, bring them back into the line. Oh no, I got one. Penalty. Don't run away from me. Great. Push them to the side. We're going to do reaching up and then hip reach, hip lift. Far. That's half of it. We're going to take again a couple of seconds rest, but not too long. I don't want your heart rate to come down. If you need to take a little bit longer because you don't do this kind of thing regularly, then that's fine. If you do, you can go through all of it and then do it all again. Okay.
Starting session.
Okay, so we start with run, run down. My brain is not impacting me. Fast. Those feet moving. This is a good exercise for agility with these toilet rolls. Especially if you've got teenagers who play sports, if you play sports, this is really going to help
with your agility and speed. Okay. Set them out. Ready to do your clock. And here we go. Up, down, up, down. Halfway. So you want to get to the back. Woo! Last one. In 10 seconds. To get all the way around. Woo! Great. Okay, squat jumps. We'll do the slightly off center. So I got a light fitting. Don't worry if you get a butt wink. You've got it tucked under here. We're going for cardio, not for weight, so. It's not gonna affect you too much. Don't let your legs go too wide though. Just keep aiming for a straight back. Good, okay. Just one knee now. Has anybody else been very tired today? It's a good thing that these workouts, yes, they're over before you know it. We have time to complain. You've done it. Nice, best time workout for me. Sometimes we want to really get along, other times just want to get it done. Good. Okay. All four. You're now supposed to get your hands in between. And feet in between. And what am I doing? Out, jump, in, jump, out, jump, in, out, and jump, in, and jump, out, and finish. Okay. So let's go for the last round. We start with quick feet. Spread them out. I'm going to try and not knock them over this time. And tap, 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 tap. Quick feet, quick feet, quick feet. Each one. Keep going, 5 seconds. Each one twice. Good. Okay. So we're going to do our reverse. I'll reach up and our reverse. Crunch. Here we go. So legs straight. If you can't get your legs straight, you can have them bent. Keep squeezing, you might put it wrong. Between your feet. And keep touching it. Good. Okay. We go under the legs, through and through, and then round in the figure of eight. Here we go. And under, under, through, through. Under, under, through, through, under, under. Get those legs up high and squeeze your abs. Through. Get down into a squat. Through, through, under, under, through, through. Okay. Take your two for the last one. In your star. Here we go. Okay. Good job. we made.
Get through that, well done. You can see I'm pretty disheveled already. So if you have more time in your hands, you haven't got kids running around or a husband who wants to use the same room to watch TV as you, or maybe that's okay for you, but not for me for filming, then you can do that again, all of it. So you end up doing, eight rounds. So we did four this time, but with four exercises on each. So, good job. Start of our week tomorrow, and Tuesday will be 2 full weeks of confinement, and that will be our last workout. So, as I said, you can follow me, Instagram, Facebook, subscribe. Oh, I think it's that side, it's the opposite way around. You know what I mean. Anyway, have a great afternoon, and I will see you tomorrow. Au revoir.